Hey, what's going on, guys? In today's video, we are inside of Affinity Designer, and I just wanted to put together a quick tutorial on reusing gradients or saving gradients, and more importantly, why you'd want to. So to get started, we're going to come over here to the left-hand side toolbar menu and just select any shape that you would like to work with. For this tutorial, I'm just going to grab a square to make it quick and easy. Just going to drag that out on the canvas, hold down the shift key to get them proportions perfect. And what we need to do now is just put a gradient on here, and we also do that on the left hand side by selecting this fill tool. And it's just a case of clicking and dragging with this at any point or angle you want to move from. So we just go down there like that. So at this point we can change the colors either over here in the scroll wheel, or we can come up on the top menu bar and we can do it in here. Doing it here gives us a few more options in terms of changing the type of the gradient, the midpoint and the opacity and the reverse, as well as having the option to add additional colors anywhere along this line simply by double tapping. And you can move that around to give you a different effect and where the gradient will lie in the middle of the shape. And you can add as many of these as you like. If for any reason you don't want this many, just simply tap on it and delete it. So we're just going to change a few colors quickly. We'll start off with that one there, and we'll just give that a light blue, and we'll just change that one to some light as well. Okay, so that will do fine for the moment. So something to quickly note is that Affinity will remember this gradient by default as it was your last color choice that you used. So if you pay attention to the right hand side, you can see right there is the gradient that we've got over here. And what that means is if we were to draw out another shape now, we'd automatically apply that gradient already. So if I come over here and grab a triangle and I just drag that out, you can see it's got the exact same gradient there as it does over here. And that will apply to any shape that you use. If we grab a circle, it does the same thing. So in order to obviously turn that off, you've got to change the color over here to something that you prefer. So I'm going to grab another shape quickly and show you another way of doing this. So say for instance you want these two shapes to have the same gradient as these ones, all we've got to do there is just select one of these two, come up to the edit menu at the top, we're going to select copy, and then we're going to select the shape that we want, which will be the circle for now, and we'll go back over to edit and we're going to paste style. So once you tap that, it copies the exact same gradient that we already had. So that's the same down here, up to edit and then to paste the style, and we've got the same gradient. So that is another way of using the same gradient or reusing it. And finally, we'll talk about how to save this gradient if you wanted to use it in the future. So to do that, we'll just once again select any of these shapes. It really doesn't matter which one. Come back up to the edit menu. This time round, we're going to come down to create style, which is that one right there. And we'll just tap in there. And once you've done that, if you come down here, you'll have a little styles menu. You may not have this on your system. If that's not showing up for you, then just head up to the top bar menu, go onto the view, down to studio, and just make sure that you do have styles checked, which is right there. And once you check that, it will show up over here. And then once we select the styles pane, if we come down here, this is our style here that we just created. So we can just completely delete all of these and we'll make a whole new shape, and then we can just apply that, and then we've always got that saved into Affinity, so you can use it any point in the future. So why would you want to do this? This is a question. Say for instance that some of you guys create icons like social media icons in your designs or something that you use again and again all the time. This is going to really speed up your workflow. So I'm going to show you a demonstration of what I mean by that. If I come over to this other document that I've created some social media icons on here, you can see I've got Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram and TikTok. And if you pay attention to my styles section down here, I've also created the gradients for these colors of these icons. So it's just as simple now as going onto the Twitter circle and selecting this Twitter gradient that I've created. And I just do that across all of these, and you can see how quick it really is for me to do this because I've already made these and saved them. Then we choose that TikTok one, which is right there. So you can generally see how quick that was just to color these icons straight away. And if I just Command Z or Control Z on Windows, just to go back and put this back to how we started, you can also apply these to the graphic itself. So if I go into the Twitter and I select that curve, I could also give that the same gradient and just leave the background grey if you wanted to. Same with the YouTube. We can come in here and colour that one red also. We have to kind of break this down a little bit by selecting all of these layers before we can change the colour of it. So then we can change that one red as well. We've already did the TikTok one before, but we'll do it again just to demonstrate. And same with the Facebook. I'm just going to close this so we can see it a little bit better. And we just select both of these parts of the Facebook and change that as well. And then finally, we can do the Instagram and just select all the curves inside of that one. So you can generally see why it's definitely useful to save your gradients if it's something that you are going to use all the time. And you see I've obviously named them down here. If you want to name the ones that you create, you just tap on that and you can just simply right click and rename that and call that anything you like. For any reason you don't want them anymore, right click once again and just delete that. So just quickly demonstrate again, we can change any of these to any different kind of gradient you would like. And that's what makes it very fast and efficient using style. So I hope this video helped you out. If you did like it, please give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to check out all my other videos. But for now, have a great day and I will see you in the next video.